Hello, y'all. It's 7:19 a.m. So after 5 o'clock, I finally got an hour and a half more of sleep. I think I did get some sleep before midnight, maybe an hour or two. So I'm feeling a sleep deprived feeling and heavy pressure on my heart. But I heard the rain is supposed to be worse today. I'm thankful it's kind of semi-warm. You know, it's perfect temperature. I think it's like 72 degrees. So it's a little bit warm. It's really nice. And the weather warmed up. Like, it was colder, like 66 degrees last night. Come on, man. The weather was 66 degrees, and then it warmed up a little bit. You know. So it warmed up a little bit overnight. I like it when it does that, kind of warm up. The temperature rise overnight. Because most of the time, the temperature would drop down overnight. But yeah, I can feel the lack of oxygen to my heart. Like, oxygen is trying to fight to get to my heart. That's how I'm feeling, like, you know. So I feel like maybe I overreacted and was mad for, like, I guess losing sleep over Trisha's two-sentence fake comment. I guess it really wasn't worth it for me to get worked up and mad and lost a few hours, like agitated and lost a few hours of sleep. But I also was, you know, angry and agitated about quite a few other things too. And, you know, the bullying and perping in general. And so, when, you know, when the world, even other professed Christians, even church folks, try to narcissistically try to make you feel like nobody like you or everybody hates you and you really are a horrible person. I mean, it helped me feel better that, you know, the Bible helped me feel like, well, I guess I ain't that horrible of a person after all, because ain't nobody better than me, you know. I'm not saying I'm better than anybody, but I'm saying you think you're better than me. So you're not better than me, like you think you're bigger, better, and higher than me. So, and God being merciful and forgiving towards us, and it's so hard to try to forgive your enemies. And, you know, even people who worship Satan secretly, they'll try to make you feel like as if they're better Christians than you, or that they're more spiritual than you. And behind closed doors, they're doing all manner of new age witchcraft, occultism, cults, mind control, black magic, and whatever else. Sexual sins too. But they front like, they try to act like as if they're public fake worship, make you feel like you ain't holy enough, or like you ain't good enough, you know, like their prayer is better than your prayer, or like they want to try to make their prayer sound fake fancy, you know, and they try to brag about their power over the devil, the same devil that they secretly serve behind closed doors. Well, this fake dirty bus is coming or what? Oh, that loud thing. All right, go. So, Here they go. And look, this thing got one headlight brighter than the other. Y'all see this? Go, dirt. Look, bus 633. So, yeah. So, it's like, I asked on Twitter, I said, how come gangs, I never heard nobody say gang stalking is an abomination to God. But y'all talking about me still being traumatized and abused, you know, is an abomination that I make excuses for. You make excuses for this abomination. But religious narcs call all your sins an abomination to God. Wow, they think that their narcissistic abuse isn't an abomination to God. Look, he's a perp, red shirt, elbow out the window, and his dog's head hanging out the window. So, hi. Yep, it's like, how you get talking about me being a demon asking for donations, and you got a comfortable, warm bed and a house protected, where you're safe, protected, and you have a purple with a red car, and you call me a demon? Trisha, you throw up devil horns. You throw up devil horns and act like a perp pretending to be Christian. I mean, but you really think that you can hide from God and play games? And look, he's a Masonic perp. He had his elbow up at the window. So yeah, I just found out that narcissistic gay nefarious Darius, that he freaking mentioned on Twitter on the biological mom's death anniversary that he tried to talk about. Oh yeah, he mentioned something about, oh, so many people want to be messy and know about targeted Creole slandering my name, and he's like, inquiring minds want to know. No, motherfucker, you know damn well I'm telling the truth, and it's you that's the fake slandering gaslighting perp. As I said, Darius, I never asked you to come in my life. Trisha, I never asked you to come in my life. Fake retarded Samantha, fake crusty Monique, all y'all, I never asked none of y'all to come in my life. But I should have said it before, you know, that when I said I'm not talking to other TIs on the phone, because y'all always turn fake. Oh, y'all been fake from the beginning and had an agenda from the beginning. Fake ass phony, all y'all. And y'all want me to be bold and not be scared. So I'm gonna be bold and speak. I've been depressed behind y'all abuse. Look at this fake ass bodacious perping, loud music. So I was trying to say that Y'all want me to not be, look, see, police. Y'all want me to not be scared, so here I am being bold and outspoken. And here's a two strange head like criminal. Damn.
Yeah, right over there.
Huh?
Seville Park, right there.
No, I think it's this way.
Kidding me?
Yeah.
What's that? Oh, dang, you're right.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Seville Square is that way. See? He let his dog get close to me, that big-ass dog.